Hello students, welcome. So we were discussing about the communication interface, few of the examples. Let us continue the third example, UART, Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter. A UART is a computer hardware device for asynchronous serial communication in which the data format and transmission speeds are configurable. It doesn't require a clock signal to synchronize the transmitting end and the receiving end of for the transmission. Instead, it relies upon the predefined agreement between the transmitting device and the receiving device. Serial communication settings like baud rate, number of bits per byte, number of start and stop bits, parity, and flow control for both transmitter and receiver should be identical. The start and stop of communication is indicated through inserting special bits in the data stream. While sending a byte of data, a start bit is added first, and a stop bit is added at the end of the bit stream. The least significant bit of the data byte follows the start bit. So let us see how this UART transmission is followed. So we have few steps. So let us go one by one. So firstly, the transmitting UART receives data in parallel from the data bus. The second step, the transmitting UART adds the start bit, parity bit, and the stop bit to the data frame. Third step, the entire packet is sent serially from the transmitting UART to the receiving UART. The receiving UART samples the data line at the pre-configured baud rate. Fourth step, the receiving UART discards the start bit, parity bit, and the stop bit from the data frame. Fifth step, the receiving UART converts the serial data back into parallel and transfer it to the data bus on the receiving end. So these are the five steps which are involved in the UART transmission. And for this transmission to be proper, the transmit line of the sending device should be connected to the receive line of the receiving device as shown in the diagram. That is UART interfacing. Along with the serial data transmission, UART provides a handshaking signal support for controlling the serial data flow. UART chips are available from different semiconductor manufacturers. Nowadays, most of the microprocessor or the microcontrollers are available with the integrated UART functionality, and they provide built-in instruction support for serial data transmission and reception. The next example is the one-wire interface. One-wire is a device communication bus system designed by Dallas Semiconductor Corporation that provides low-speed data signaling and the power over a single conductor. It is also known as Dallas one-wire protocol. It makes use of only one single signal line called DQ for communication and follows the master and slave communication model. So the bus interface diagram is shown here, the connection between the master and slave devices on a one-wire bus. So we can observe that there is only one signal line, that is DQ, which are connected from the master to the slaves. So it is somewhat similar to that of the I2C interface bus. The slave devices incorporate internal capacitor to power the device from the signal line. The one-wire interface supports a signal supports a single master and one or more slave devices on the bus. Since it supports more number of slaves, it needs a number to be stored in each slave. That is, it contains a 64-bit identification number stored in it to differentiate the slaves. So the sequence of operation for communicating with a one-wire slave device is listed here. The master device sends a reset pulse on the one-wire bus. The slave device present on the bus respond with a presence pulse. The master device sends a ROM command, and this address the slave to which it wants to communicate or it wants to initiate a communication. Fourth step, the master device sends a read or write function command to read or write the internal memory or registers of the slave device. Last sequence is that the master initiates a read or write data from the device or to the device. So it is all, the communication is all the master initiated. The communication over a one bus is divided into time slots of 60 microseconds. So for reading and writing, it is time slots are divided. So for writing a bit value of 1, so 1 to 15 microseconds are required. That is, for writing bit value of 1 on 1 wire bus, the bus master pulls the bus for 1 to 15 microseconds and then releases the bus for the rest of the time slot. For writing bit value of 0 on the bus, by master pulling the bus for a minimum of 1 time slot, that is 60 microseconds, and the maximum of 2 time slots, that is 120 microseconds. To read a bit from the slave device, the master pulls the bus low for 1 to 15 microseconds. So in the same way, if the slave wants to send a bit value 1 in response to the read request from the master, it simply releases the bus for the rest of the time slot. So if the slave wants to send a bit value 0, it pulls the bus low for the rest of the time slot. So this is how the time slots are divided. So the next last example in this part is the parallel interface. So it's used for communication with the peripheral devices, which are memory mapped to the host of the system. The diagram shows the bus interface diagram for interfacing of the devices to the parallel interface. So the host has a parallel bus and a control over read or write. So the communication through the parallel bus is controlled by the control signal interface between the host and the device. The control signals are the read or write signals here, and they are called as device select signals. So device becomes active by selecting the host processor. Direction of data transfer are controlled through the control signal lines for read and write. An address decoder circuit is used for generating chip select signal for the device. So when the address selected is in the range, the chip select is activated by the decoder circuit. If device wants to start the communication, it can inform the same to processor through the interrupts. So the main advantage is that the parallel data communication offers the highest speed for the data transfer. So this is all about the few examples of the onboard communication interfaces in the communication interface. Thank you.